Sarah Seidner's just been speaking to the governor of Hawaii. Sarah, what did you get?
So the question to him was, how did this happen? And that's what everybody wants to know. He also did mention that not only was a text sent out, but there were those, and we're all familiar with that, when the television and the radio beeps out that sound that this is an emergency alert. That also happened. And so he was saying, look, I am down at the emergency management area where this all happened. There was a shift change, the governor said. And during that shift change, it was a routine shift change, someone accidentally, and this is how he put it, pressed the wrong button. And that sent out the alert, not only to cell phones, but also the emergency alert to television stations, as well as the radio stations. They immediately tried to get on the phone with the radio and television stations to tell them that this was a false alarm. But it took a while for them to deal with the text as well. I think there was also a reaction because, of course, he himself did not know whether this was real or not. So he took it upon himself to go down to the emergency management with Vern Miyagi, who's the administrator, and try to sort out what exactly was going on. Now, they do realize this has caused confusion, this has caused fear. They are trying to get to the bottom of how this happened and trying to figure out how to make sure that it never happens again. But they have been proactive in the fact that they have been testing. They are the first state in the country to test their sirens, which, by the way, they had not used since the end of the Cold War. So we're talking, 20, 30 years ago. And at this point, they're saying, look, yes, they have egg on their face. This should not have happened. But they are trying to figure out what to do in case, and to be prepared in case there is such an attack. And globally what's happening with our president, the president of the United States, and Kim Jong-un of North Korea, that tension has ratcheted up. But they indeed started looking at this several months before things got as intense as they have. For example, when the fire and fury comment was made by President Trump, I happened to be inside of that bunker, and the reaction inside the bunker was, oh, my goodness. Mm-hmm. So the danger is, of course, and what everyone has been talking about, when tensions get high, sometimes mistakes are made. But this, they said, was, look, someone literally pressed the wrong button.
So just to be clear, Sarah, then the governor seems to be explaining that this was not some kind of hack. This was not an instance like that. This was actually a human error of some kind.
Exactly. He said it was a mistake made during a standard procedure at the changeover of a shift, and an employee pushed the wrong button. That is exactly how he put it.